All right. Hello, everybody. Let me get Instagram started. What is happening? Instagram and Facebook. Trying a couple of different things today. I've got Instagram up here. I've got Facebook right here. Be nice if we could have it like a split screen. One side be Facebook and one side be Instagram. That would be a whole lot nicer than going back and forth, probably. But the information is still going to get out, so that's okay. So, welcome to the last Monday of January. Hope the month has been good to you. Let me move Facebook a little bit. I hope the month has been good to you so far. I can't believe it's already the end of January of 2020. This month has felt so long. I don't know if it's felt long to you, but certainly felt long to me in a good way, of course. But month of January, we've really talked about, hey y'all, talked about goals. Goals are so important. And kind of bring my notes over here. We talked about goals in a couple of different aspects. I kind of wanted to wrap up today. Hello. Wrap up today with goals. Kind of finish that out. Not to say that we won't keep talking about them. Because one problem that we have is we set those goals in January and then we forget about them. They're gone, right? We don't return to them. That's something that we want to do. That is something that we want to make sure that we are addressing. And that's what we're going to do. That's what I'm going to continue to help you do in these Monday meetings, right? Helping you to get to those goals and look at them again and again. So today, kind of wanted to go back through what we've talked about this month and make sure that we understand what we're doing with our goals, okay? Finish up with the main topic, main objective with goals. Kind of work on this camera again. I'll talk to my camera guys, see if I can get him to fix this. And then we'll talk a little bit about February, what the February Monday meetings are going to be about, and a special offer challenge that I am going to do for the month of February and going on after that. But you have to stay tuned. You have to watch the whole thing. So when we talk about goals, first step, just recapping, are the goals for you or are they for somebody else? Make sure that the goal, whatever you're writing down, whatever you're thinking about, whatever you're focused on, is your goal and not somebody else's goal. Okay? Do you want to lose weight? Great. But do you want to, or does somebody else want you to? So make sure that goal is specific for you. Okay? After that, how do we set them up? So setting up goals is pretty fun. Okay. You don't want to just set a goal and forget it, right? Because what happens? You set this huge goal, and then 8, 9, 10 months, a year later, you look at your goals, you're nowhere near them. So let's break those goals down into smaller chunks. I like to do it quarterly. One example that I have shared is I want to read 20 books this year. And that's going to be reading or audiobooks. There's both. And instead of concentrating on 20, I'm going to concentrate on five. I almost said four. Five in each quarter. And I'm going to focus on that five number. And if I can hit that five, then I know I'll hit the 20. Same thing with losing weight or starting an exercise program or eating better, whatever it is, break that goal down into a smaller chunk, okay? Break it down, it makes it more attainable. Then we talk about how many we should have. Sometimes people will set so many goals, right? Let me fix my screen here. They set so many goals that they get overwhelmed and they don't know which one to pick. Which goal should I pick? Which one's more important? Well, they're all important, right? They're all important. But when you have too many, you may get overwhelmed. I like to break down my goals into maybe 4 or 5 per quarter that lead me to the main goals of the year that I want to accomplish. So one of my goals is to really develop my Instagram and my Facebook audience and help as many people as I possibly can. So in order to do that, that's my main goal. I want 5,000 people in my Facebook group. I have a little over 600 right now, right? So how do we do that? How do I do that? Every Monday, I have a meeting at 6 p.m. with you. That is a habit goal that I can work on quarterly, okay? So that's how I'm working on this to develop my audience. And what happens? Every month, every week, I get a few more people. I love it when people wave at me. I see you. Anybody just joining, I've got Instagram right here and I've got Facebook right here. I'm kind of going back and forth, trying not to make you too dizzy. But that's how we want to break our goals up, okay? And looking at how many that we have. So now, after you set them all up, what do you do with them? I mean, what do you do with these goals? Do you write them down? Do you share them? I encourage sharing them. Now, you don't have to share all of them. Some of them are going to be personal. We know that. Some of them are going to be embarrassing maybe to you, not to anybody else. Because here's something to think about, okay? When you think that a goal is embarrassing or when you think a goal is too personal, think about it from the other side. Think about it from the other perspective, okay? What happens if someone shared that specific goal, the one that you're embarrassed about, with you? How would that make you feel? That would make you feel great that that person trusts you enough to share that goal, right? So that's something to remember when you're thinking about sharing a goal or wanting someone else to participate in your goal, okay? The last thing and the main objective or main topic that I want you to think about as we move forward with goals, okay? Something that I've recently started, and it is a little tough. It's forced me to look at my goals a lot more than what I'm used to. And that is writing them down. Let me move in front. There we go. Writing them down. Writing my goals down, not just once, daily. Hello. Has completely changed how I approach my goals. Because what's happened is every day I write them down, sometimes twice. They're stuck in my head. They're right there in front of me. So my actions and my daily intentions change to hit those goals. So I want to read 20 books in the year. So I've broken that down to 5 this quarter. Every day I'm writing down books, 5 books this quarter. What does that make me do? I automatically start thinking, oh, I need to read a book today. I need to read. I need to make sure that I set aside 30 minutes, an hour, whatever I have. Maybe it's 5 minutes to read something to get me to my goal. But by putting that in front of my face daily, has shifted my mindset. Okay? Keeps you focused. Now, some people will type. I don't think that works at all. I think you should write it. Now, I will make this one exception. This is what I use. I use my iPad. Now, my iPad has a pen, so I'll write on my iPad. What I like with this is I'll use the note function. So if you're not Apple, sorry. I'm sure Android has something that's probably better. But this is what I have. I will write using the notes function on my iPad, and it automatically gets transferred to my computer, my Mac, and my iPhone. And I can see it all at the same time, which is extremely convenient, right? And I can always pull that up and look at, oh, hey, there's my goals. I wrote them down. Oh, am I working towards reading those 5 books or having all those podcasts done? One of my other goals is to do 4 podcasts, record 4 podcasts by the end of the month, right? I'm putting that in front of my face every day. So it's forcing me to get there. Okay? Getting notifications while I'm doing this. I'm going to try to multitask a little bit. So that's probably the biggest game changer that I've used to help me get to my goals quicker. I've already started watching my mind shift a little bit just by writing them down every day. And I really would encourage you to do the same thing. Okay? So I don't see any questions yet on some of those goal objectives that I've talked about. So I want to talk about 2 things that we're getting ready with February. We're going to keep coming back to goals, okay? So don't worry, all right? Like I said at the beginning, a lot of times we start thinking too much about goals, we forget about our goals. We don't think too much about them. And what happens? We miss our goals. We pull them up at the end of the year and they're gone. So we're going to revisit these probably monthly. We'll just talk about them quickly during these Monday meetings. February, starting next week. We may have to shift a little bit next week. I'll figure it out. I've got a Cub Scout meeting maybe for my kids at 6. So I have to find out some information on that. So I may do this a little bit earlier. We may shift it to Tuesday. Stay tuned. Either way, it's recorded so you can watch it. But February, we're going to start talking about nutrition. Nutrition. Each week in February, we are going to break down nutrition. Okay? We're going to talk about maybe some fads. We're going to talk about, and let me pull it up and I'll tell you exactly what we are going to be talking about. We're going to talk about some macros, what macros are. We're going to talk about myths. We're going to talk about diet protocols, how you actually lose weight. We're going to talk about, you know, what's the story with carbs? What's the story with protein? Is it really bad for you if you eat too much? What's this thing about eating breakfast or not eating breakfast, and what's more important? We're going to talk about all of those broken down through the month, just like we're doing now. And this is going to continue. March, we're going to talk about movement. April, we're going to talk about supplements. May, we're going to start talking about some kids and what kids should do. And sprinkled in everywhere is things that are specific to you. So continue to ask questions, and I'll continue to address exactly what you're asking. Okay? Last thing that I want to, or the thing that I'll leave you with before I'll answer questions, if there are some. Another question that I get asked commonly is, or it's more of a statement I want to exercise. I want to work out. I just don't have time. I get it. I totally understand. If you have asked that, if you have said that, if you have thought that, this is why I'm here. This is specifically why I'm doing this. Because quite frankly, I'm tired of the trainers and fitness enthusiasts trying to tell you that they can find an hour in your schedule. Okay? Sure, I could find an hour in your schedule. That doesn't mean you want to work out for an hour. So starting February 1st, which is coming up next week, I'm starting a monthly habit challenge for you. And that habit challenge each month is going to have a different habit that we are going to try to create for you. Starting in February, we are working on the habit of movement. Every day, you are going to get an email from me with a video showing you an exercise to do. And here's the best part. It's 30 seconds or less every day. Now, if you want to do more, do more. It's fantastic. I love it. Give me at least 30 seconds. You see the email? Let's do 30 seconds. How do you get involved? Right? I know that's the next question. How do I get involved? It's 30 seconds of work, 30 seconds of exercise. I want to do it, right? You need to go to my website. In my website, go to plans and pricing. Under plans and pricing, you will see it's at the bottom, habit challenge. I think it's called habit challenge. Go there, and let me pull it up real quick just to make sure I'm telling you correctly, because I have four options on my page, and we want to be correct. It's the habit change plan. It's what I titled it. It's $2.99 a month, not $299 a month. $2.99 a month for you to get an email from me every single day for a 30-second exercise. That's it. Because I want to help you develop the habit of exercise. Will this get you ripped? Hey, Jason, I see you, man. Will this get you ripped? No, but it'll start the process, and it'll get you to where you want to be. Hey, Alex. So if you just joined and you want to start exercising, you want to start that habit of exercising starting in February, let's go. Go to my website, check out the habit change plan, and every day I'm going to send you an exercise to do that's 30 seconds or less. You've got no excuses now. I don't need an hour of your time. I don't want an hour of your time. You're busy. You have plenty of things to do. These are going to be exercises you can do right here in your chair while you're watching me, while you're scrolling through Instagram or Facebook, whatever it might be, while you are getting ready in the morning before you go to bed at night. That's what this is geared for. That's specifically who I want to help. I want to help you. So let me do that. Thank you for joining me tonight. This was about a 20-minute talk. If you've got questions, I'll stay on here for a little bit. My kids are just sitting down for dinner. Fix them some dinner tonight. We've got chicken and rice and some green beans that they should be munching on right now. So I'm open and I'm here to answer questions. Yes, some of the exercises will be modified or modifiable. There are approximately, I've got them all listed out right now. There's three or four exercises that will repeat just because they're very effective. Now, When I say they'll repeat, we may change them up just slightly, okay? But that's just, I want to give you the most bang for your buck in that short 30-second time frame. Hey, Jason, yeah, it's $2.99 a month. That's how much the monthly program is. And this is something that we are starting. I'm starting right now. Starts February, which is going to be the movement month. Okay. After that, moving on through the months, we're going to do nutrition habit change. We're going to do a water habit change, other types of movement change. We have to think about, absolutely, it's cheap. Yes, because I want to help so many people. I want to help everybody. And to do that, we need to change one small habit. So join me. I want you. Join me. Go to my website. Sign up. We're starting February 1st. I want you in. Have a great rest of the night. If you just joined, if you're catching this later, send me a question. If you've got questions, I would love to answer them. And let's go. Have a great night.